with the final straw in the McMahon family saga. Vince meets his son Shane in the ring. Plus, the pierced Prince Albert is in one-on-one action with PMS's prime cut, Meat. And it was Rock versus Stone Cold, and Shane McMahon had a huge surprise in store for the Brahma Bull and the Texas Rattlesnake. All that and a whole lot more on Shotgun. Saturday night. The wild week rolls along in the WWF as we kick off Shotgun Saturday night with Draws' personal piercings to tattoo artist, Prince Albert. And it was just 2 weeks ago on SmackDown that we saw Prince Albert with a piercing needle about a foot long attempt to pierce D'Lo Brown's tongue with sexual chocolate. Mark Henry made his return in style.
Accompanied by the Boston Mets, weighing in at 370 pounds, Prince Albert.
Take a look at this horse, 370 pounds of Prince Albert. He is not only big, but he's double bad. Straight, Jim. A few weeks ago, PMS, Jacqueline, and Terry swore off men, but I think Meats brought him back into the stable.
Well, I think the problem is that before, the men were too unreliable, but in this case, from what I understand of Meat personally, he's got a $1 million body and a 10-cent brain. He's very easy to control, and that's what PMS likes about him the best.
Our opportunity here on Shotgun Saturday night to see Meat in action for the first time, and it should be an interesting matchup. And then you see Draws, the number of piercings, the nose ring, the tongue ring, and look at the piercing on this guy.
How does he get through the metal detector at the airport? Two tremendous young athletes, and well, PMS with a little good luck rub for Meat. Two tremendous young athletes here in the World Wrestling Federation. We have seen Prince Albert do a variety of horrifying things, or try to do them, to Draws his enemies, but he's an accomplished wrestler as well, and this Meat, I haven't seen him in the ring too much, but he is put together like $1 million. Like I said, just got the empty head, which makes him easier to handle.
And Prince Albert now set to lock up with Meat, but Meat gonna take his time here. And folks, you saw this past week on Raw, The Rock and Stone Cold being tossed off the stage at the hands of Triple H and The Undertaker. We understand Stone Cold Steve Austin suffered bruised ribs. We understand The Rock suffered a broken arm in the fall.
That's right, that stage has gotta be 10 or 12 feet up in the air, and the only thing down there to break their fall was a variety of furniture that they went straight through. So it was not a very happy landing for either The Rock or Stone Cold.
We're going to show you that matchup, Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Rock, a bit later on. But we can tell you this, tomorrow night on Sunday Night Heat, live at 7 o'clock, 6 Central on USA from Jacksonville, Florida, The Rock is going to be there. And for the first time since the carnage on Raw, will speak out about the situation.
And I've got to question the wisdom of a man, even a man with the guts of The Rock, coming to the Heat location with a broken arm. He may be easy pickings for the corporate ministry.
Here's a reversal now by Prince Albert. Definitely with the size and strength advantage. And there you see it. A power slam by Prince Albert.
Caught him in there and took him right over and Meat. He looks like he's about ready to be ground hamburger right now. And what about the situation between Vince and Shane McMahon, Michael? It's unbelievable. We actually saw a father and son meet in the ring one-on-one on Raw.
Shane McMahon has gone completely over the edge. This past week on Raw, he told his mother to shut up, challenged his father to a match in the ring, and then admitted that he was the brainchild. He was behind the abduction of his own sister, Stephanie, at the hands of The Undertaker, just to seize control of the WWF.
That's right, he did it all just to take his father's attention off of business so that he could have the corporation his way. And look at that scissors kick right to the face of Meat, and Meat is down, and Prince Albert standing over and goes for the cover.
Here's the cover now, hook of the leg, and Meat kicks out. We're going to show you Shane Vince one-on-one a little bit later on, but Shane told his father, I've already taken your dignity, I've already taken your company, and now it's time for me to take your backside.
Oh, man, look at that over-the-knee backbreaker, and Prince Albert trying to break Meat in half. And you know, Shane McMahon has more to worry about, though, than his father, because we saw on Monday night the formation of the union, a bunch of disgruntled ex-corporate members who've been jacked around and jacked over by Shane McMahon and his cronies have decided to band together, and it's a pretty impressive assembly. Ken Shamrock test the Big Show and Mankind forming the union? And make no mistake about it, Jim, these four guys aren't friends. They're not buddies. They're not going to hang out and watch TV together. But what they did was form this union, so to speak, because there are strength in numbers, and they know that they need a union to combat the corporate ministry.
You're exactly right, and a strong assemblage they are in the corporate ministry. They're almost unstoppable, but if anybody is up to the task, it's the men who have formed the union.
Here now, Meat whipped across the ring, into the turnbuckle, and Prince Albert now in control of Meat. Sidewalk slam. Hook of the leg. This one should be over. There's two, and Meat gets the shoulder up.
The tremendous young athletes that you see in the World Wrestling Federation, these two men, just another example. Always fresh faces, always fresh meat, so to speak, Michael. And if you saw a few minutes ago, Prince Albert in the middle of beating Meat down, punched him in the stomach, those washboard abs, and he hurt his hand, he hurt his fist.
Draws has got that piercing kit open, fooling around with the needles there as Prince Albert looks on.
Well, I don't know about that stuff. I'd rather, beautiful chicken wing, double arm suplex, and this guy can wrestle as well as fight.
I got the big one for you, brother.
Well, he's asking for a piercing needle.
He has got the big one, all right. It looks like it's about a foot long, and I don't think the... Wait a minute.
Whoa! Here's a cover. Prince Albert reversal. Hooked the leg, but too late.
Meat tried to get out of that thing and take him up for a slam, but 370 pounds, and Meat's weak in condition. Too much for him, and Prince Albert clotheslines the man back down, and he is in charge. Let's hope that that needle does not come in the ring.
Well, can you imagine if Meat does get pierced? What do you think PMS would think about that? I wonder where they'd pierce him.
Well, it depends on where it would go as to whether the girls would like it, but I'll guarantee you this, Meat's not going to like it under any circumstances, because after all, the only thing to do with Meat after you pierce it is go ahead and marinate it.
You saw the nice close-up there on the face of Prince Albert. He's got those piercings in his lips, his nose, his ears.
That's the places that we can see.
And look at this now, Meat slammed down. Prince Albert in control. Tremendous athlete at 370 pounds, Prince Albert. But perhaps tiring a little bit here. He takes a quick breather, now to the second rope.
That is the advantage that a guy like Meat's going to have over a guy the size of Prince Albert. Oh, nobody home in the pool.
And Meat moves out of the way, and Prince Albert now in trouble. As Meat tries to get some momentum, and his bevy of cheerleaders, Jacqueline and Terry, looking on.
This Prince Albert moves like a cat for a man that size, and he's got tremendous strength. But as the match wears on, a guy in the stamina, the conditioning of Meat, is going to come to the forefront, and here he comes.
Meat with a drop kick to the stomach. And Prince Albert in deep trouble.
Meat took his legs right out from under him with that one, and now Meat going to the top. He's got a second win, and he's got the opportunity to put this one away and make PMS happy, and Draws very sad.
Prince Albert in La La Land. Here's the cross body.
Good Lord.
Close to the cover. There's the hook of the leg.
Almost three.
And Prince Albert got the shoulder up.
He just squeaked out of that one, that high cross body, two-thirds of the way across this ring. And now Meat once again with Prince Albert staggered on Weird Street.
Draws having words with PMS outside the ring as Meat, instead of going for a cover here, is more interested in posing for Terry and Jacqueline.
Meat, don't make a mistake, pal. We said you weren't too bright, but you're a heck of an athlete.
Meat with a slam now of Prince Albert, who's in trouble. Here's Meat now, quickly into the cover. Hooks the leg, there's two and again. Prince Albert kicks out.
Meat still with the opportunity here to put this one away. Had 370 pounds of Prince Albert up in the slam, and Meat now taking it to Prince Albert. Prince Albert has not been able to create an opening in the past couple of minutes.
Perhaps this is it. Reversal into the turnbuckle. Here comes Meat. Look at the strength of Prince Albert. Slams him down. Meat rolls him over. Hooks the leg. Meat.
He
picks
it
up the win.
He got it.
And wisely scoots out of the ring as Draws heads in. And I wonder what Meat's reward's going to be.
Well, I'd like to be a fly on the wall for it, but nevertheless, Meat the winner. But it could have gone either way.
And still to come tonight, everybody gets what they want when Al Snow heads down to the ring.
But coming up next, a reluctant Mr. McMahon enters the ring to face his disrespectful son, Shane. And we'll take a look.
Welcome back, everybody. This portion of tonight's show being brought to you by the motor oil that provides maximum protection. Castrol GTX. Drive hard. and by Burger King, where you can have the delicious King of Fries, Burger King. When you have it your way, it just tastes better, Michael.
And by WWF The Music Volume 3. Hear the original entrance theme songs of your favorite WWF superstars. On sale now at all Sam Goody and Musicland stores and other fine retailers.
Vince McMahon tried to make one final attempt to reach his son Shane to talk some sense into the power-hungry boy wonder. Even Shane's mother Linda and sister Stephanie were there as well to try to reconcile.
I think you're about to make a big mistake. And I think you better think long and hard before you do.
You better listen, Shane.
And you better get your stuff together, because your family is not standing behind you.
Nor should they.
Come on, you want to bring it? I'm right here for you, Vinnie Mac.
Oh, come
on. How about me and you? Think of the box office, Vince. You know what? I've taken your company out from under you. I've taken everything. The only thing I want to take now is your ass.
Oh, my gosh. Is Shane challenging his own father to fight him here tonight?
Think of the box office. Vince versus Shane in this very ring. How about it, Pop?
He is. That's what he's talking about. No way. Not right.
Nope. The answer is no. But if you won't listen to me, if you won't listen to your sister, Stephanie, then maybe just maybe your mother, Linda, maybe you'll listen to her.
Shane, I'm begging you, son. In the name of our family,
shut your mouth, Mom!
Oh, come on!
Let's see!
Yeah, get it,
you want me to come at it right now! Right now, me and you!
Mr. McMahon, surrounded. Don't do anything foolish, Mr. McMahon! Well, that's getting his wife and his daughter out of here, out of this ring anyway. Vince surrounded by the corporate ministry. What an insolent human being is Shane McMahon. And the crowd chanting for what they'd like to see Vince do to his son.
Can you believe he told his own mother to shut up?
I can't. No, I can't. Absolutely not. It is disrespectful and pathetic. It is a sad day in the McMahon family, I can tell you that. I could only imagine how they must
feel. Hey, Vince, you know what? I could have them do it again.
Do what?
Who do you think was the mastermind behind the Undertaker abducting your little girl, Stephanie?
What? Oh, come on, no.
It was me.
Good what? God.
I knew if Daddy's little girl was in a weakened position that you would crumble. that you would leave the business like a hot potato, and I was there to pick up the pieces. How do you think The Undertaker got into our house? How do you think he got Stephanie's little teddy bear? How do you think that the pictures were taken?
It was Shane.
It was all me.
That's sick.
And Stephanie, who do you think picked out your wedding dress? Wasn't it the bomb?
My God.
I can't.
Hey, wait a minute. No, don't do it. Yeah, don't do it. Big cover the ring. Miss McMahon now trying to get a piece of his son, Shane. But what he's getting is an assault, a beating from the corporate ministry. They're all over him. The entire ministry. We need help. The corporate ministry having their way with Vince McMahon here. Look at the Undertaker. And look at his own son, Shane. Shane's mother and his sister looking on. This is not right. This is the most shocking thing I think I've ever seen here on Raw.
That final display of disrespect was the straw that broke the camel's back for Vince McMahon, and he had no other choice but to meet his son Shane in the ring. But Shane threw another obstacle in his father's path, an attack by the corporate ministry. But nothing would stop Vince McMahon from meeting his son in the ring.
Vince barely able to stand. He can't stand. He's been brutalized by Shane's corporate ministry.
No, I can't believe he's going to do this.
Just contorted with rage.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah, now Bronco Buster. You can see it coming. Oh. Shane McMahon with a Bronco Buster on his own father.
What a power trip this kid is on, JR. This is unbelievable.
Boy, we need an ego intervention here. Well, this kid has gone absolutely off over the edge.
Stay upon the hair.
Vince can barely stand. This is... basically academic here.
Ooh.
Got another knockdown. Remember, Vince McMahon, before he went to the commercial break, was assaulted in his own office by The Undertaker and Triple H. And Shane, really, he's full of himself, isn't he?
I tell you what,
I like to buy him for what he's worth and sell him for what he thinks he's worth right now. I cannot believe father versus son. Wait a minute.
Oh, man, did you see that? A huge clothesline by Vince.
Vince McMahon got a clothesline, maybe out of desperation, on his own son here. Oh, wait. Oh, the stunner.
A stunner.
Stone Cold Stunner.
A stunner.
Vince McMahon, you Stone Cold Stunner. The leg is hooked. Vince has beaten Shane.
Come tonight, Shane wasn't through yet, forcing The Rock to meet Stone Cold with a surprising conclusion.
But up next, it's always a treat when Al Snow drops by for a talk. And in this case, I'm going to give the task to my broadcast partner, Michael.
Thanks.
What does everybody want?
Welcome back to Shotgun Saturday Night, everybody. And at this point, we're going to be treated to some words of wisdom from one of the more bizarre, unfocused individuals in the World Wrestling Federation, Al Snow.
Ladies and gentlemen, the WWF Hardcore Champion, Al Snow!
Of course, Al Snow without head, who is still in the possession of Hardcore Holly, who is attempting to extort a Hardcore Championship match from Al Snow by keeping head prisoner. Al Snow, of course, very despondent without head, but he feels that head is the Hardcore Champion since head was on top of the man when the pin was made. Basically, I think, folks, Al Snow needs a psychiatrist, a dermatologist, and about 16 other types of medical doctors to sort out his various psychological problems. Take it away, Michael.
Al, plain and simple, Hardcore Holly has demanded a rematch, but the question everyone wants to know is, why won't you give him one? He gave you one.
Todd, why are you so cruel? Are you that much of an inhuman monster that you've got to make me relive that night over again? Huh? My life is falling apart, Todd. Don't you understand?
Todd?
You were there at Backlash, you saw.
I guess he does kind of look like him.
You,
Yeah, I saw, but... God,
you know what this belt means to me? You know what this belt means to both of us? To all of us? I am the Crown Prince of Hardcore, and Head is now the champion. Now, can I give Bob Holly a rematch?
Wait a minute, that's Bob Holly! Hardcore Holly is in the ring with Head, and he just smacked Al Snow right in the back of the skull, and now Al Snow is down, and Holly's standing over him.
Maybe you didn't quite understand what I told you last week. You'll get that stupid piece of crap back when you give me a hardcore title shot, pal.
Well, Michael Cole cowering in the corner. Michael, you better get out of there. Al Snow is unconscious, and Holly once again reiterating his demands for a hardcore championship match. It's extortion. He'll not return Head to Al Snow until he gets what he wants. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be back with some more action if we can just get Al Snow out of the ring. But coming up next, folks, the Brahma Bull and the Rattlesnake forced to face each other, instead fight side by side for their very lives.
1-800-COLLECT presents WWF Over the Edge in just 2 weeks live, Sunday, May 23rd from the sold-out Kemper Arena in Kansas City. 1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two.
Well, folks, this past Monday, firmly on a power trip, Shane McMahon scheduled a lumberjack match between Stone Cold and The Rock with the corporate ministry surrounding the ring. But the intentions of the match became quite clear when the bell rang and Stone Cold, Steve Austin, and The Rock were in a fight for their lives against enormous odds.
Oh, look at this!
And here they go.
Wait a minute!
The lumberjacks! Here come the lumberjacks, just as we thought!
The lumberjacks setting up Austin, and here comes Shane! Shane McMahon now coming out!
I'm telling you, Shane is a mastermind! This was a setup from the beginning! He never intended for The Rock to face Stone Cold Steve Austin! He just wanted to get him in the middle of the ring so that then the corporate ministry could do their bidding with him like they're doing right now!
The corporate ministry now invading the ring. And look at this mass attack, this mismatch, and Austin beginning to suffer at the hands of The Undertaker. They've got him now, Helmsley, with some shots to The Rock. And what, hey look, there's Vince McMahon. Vince sending the troops down here. Vince telling the union to go get it on, to go get you some.
What?
All over the arena here, now focused on Helmsley and The Rock. And The Rock responding to the tents. Knocks down Helmsley. He just hit.
Against Eric Spration, we just saw how dangerous the corporate ministry can be. Stone Cold Steve Austin suffering bruised ribs in his fall, The Rock breaking an arm.
And the question is, who is going to be able to stop the corporate ministry? We've talked about the formation of the union of former disgruntled corporation members, but there's still only four men. Stone Cold and The Rock, only two men, albeit very capable two men, but the question is, just by sheer numbers alone and the power of Shane McMahon, who can stop the corporate ministry?
And Over the Edge in just 2 weeks, The Undertaker, of the corporate ministry meets Stone Cold for the title. Triple H of the corporate ministry meets The Rock. And how about this huge match just added? The Union meets the corporate ministry in an eight-man tag team match, Survivor Rules.
That's right. That it means as a man is pinned or disqualified, he's eliminated. It could be a three-on-one, even a four-on-one situation by the time that match is over with. And the last man in the ring for his team will be the winner.
And will The Rock be able to compete against Triple H and Over the Edge? Well, perhaps we'll find out tomorrow night, broken arm and all. The Rock will be on Sunday Night Heat Live, 7 o'clock, 6 central on USA from Jacksonville, Florida. I'm sure The Rock's going to have plenty to say.
Well, you know he is, because The Rock generally has plenty to say anyway in a situation where he has suffered a broken arm as a result of an attack by someone. He's going to have plenty to say, and I would think something up his sleeve to do.
Midian now in control of Eric's Brasher. We saw Midian involved in that four-quarter match, which was actually a three-on-one against Test this past week. We saw Test pull off a huge upset when the Boss Man inadvertently hit Midian with his nightstick. And I think what we saw there, Jim, was you got to keep in mind the corporate ministry's only been together a few short weeks now. They have to learn to work to each other, learn about each other's personalities. And keep in mind, for somebody like the Boss Man, just a couple of weeks ago, he was serious enemies with these guys. Now he's got to get along with them.
Well, you know, the whole problem stems back to Shane McMahon. He does have the power. He does have the power to move and shake and make these calls and make these matches, but he doesn't have the maturity that Vince McMahon did. He doesn't have the experience that Vince McMahon did. So, Shane McMahon, be careful what you ask for, because you just might get it. And in the case of the matches that he signed last Monday, more often than not, it backfired on him.
Here's Midian now whipping Sprace into the ropes, and there's a big clothesline. Yeah, one of the matches that backfired on him, we mentioned Test getting the victory over the corporate ministry. But how far will Shane McMahon go, Jim, in this quest for power in the WWF? Apparently, as you see Midian now go for the cover, and Sprace puts his foot on the rope. Apparently, Shane gave The Undertaker his marching orders in his match against The Big Show. Not only did The Undertaker try to use ether in his elbow pad, he cracked The Big Show over the head with a baseball bat, knocking the seven-footer out.
That's right, and it wasn't The Undertaker. Let's bear in mind, it was not The Undertaker that knocked The Big Show out. It was the baseball bat, which splintered on the head of The Big Show. I've never seen a man that big, that strong, that powerful knocked out before. It had to be a tremendous blow, but that just goes to show that The Undertaker and Shane are willing to go to any lengths to get what they want.
Here's Midian now, Sprayship Bulldog by Midian.
Modified Bulldog there just brought him right down on the side of his head. And you know something else that I enjoyed seeing was that big matchup. Wait a minute, cover here. No, it's a blatant choke. The big matchup that Shane McMahon signed, the old versus the new. The old Stooges versus the new Stooges. And in this case, Pat Patterson and Gerald Briscoe, God bless their veteran hearts, beat the Mean Street Posse within a half an inch of their skunk-headed, weird haircutted life, and I loved every second of it.
How do you really feel, Jim? As Sprayshaw now hammers away on Midian.
I try not to sugarcoat these things.
Sprayshaw went for the dropkick. Midian held on. And Midian again in control.
They hit, I'll tell you something, Patterson and Briscoe hit those two punks so hard, it turned the alligators on their shirts into lizards.
And Midian now, Sprayshaw in trouble. There's the neck breaker. Forget about this one. Sprayshaw may not get up. Here's the cover. And folks, this one's over. Midian with quick work of Eric Sprayshaw.
Here is your winner, Midian.
Tremendous impact on that reverse neck breaker. He snapped it right off after he'd already dropped the man on the side of his head. And this Midian, look at that eyeball in a jar. Probably the strangest member of the corporate ministry, Michael.
Just stick around. We got plenty more to come on Shotgun Saturday Night. Hardcore Holly, we saw him earlier on. He's in action. Coming up next.
And now, the WWF Rewind, brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two.
I am the Crown Prince of Hardcore, and Head is now the champion. Now, can I give Bob Holly a rematch?
Oh, Hardcore Holly is attacked, Al Snow.
Get that stupid piece of crap back when you give me a hardcore title shot, pal.
The hardcore title situation is not over yet. Holly wants revenge.
That was the WWF Rewind, brought to you by 1-800-COLLECT. Save a buck or two.
Well, Hardcore Holly, not in a pleasant mood, to say the least. And I guess we can say he's holding Head hostage.
And Al Snow has been forced to leave the building.
The contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Mobile, Alabama, weighing 232 pounds, Hardcore Holly.
So Hardcore Holly set for action against Central Delta, but I guess you really can't blame Hardcore. Hardcore Holly. He wants the rematch, but Al Snow is such a whack job. He's such a nut. He actually believes that that mannequin head is the Hardcore champion.
Well, and as a result, Al Snow feels that it's not his prerogative to give Hardcore Holly a rematch for the Hardcore title. So Holly has chosen this method of extortion, and he's not treating Head with very much respect. And let's face it, in the team of Al Snow and Head, after all, Head is the brains of the outfit.
Well, to be honest now, Jim, I don't think that Hardcore Holly's playing with a full deck either. Anybody that gets involved in this Hardcore division has got to have a few screws loose, to say the least. I mean, you put your body through a tremendous amount of punishment in that division.
Well, I don't think Hardcore Holly is in any way deranged or stupid. As much as he is, he's a tough man who wants to prove himself. Holly in his past has been a professional race car driver, has always enjoyed contact sports, always wanted to get in there and hear the smack of flesh on flesh, and that's what he's doing in the Hardcore division. He's just taking it to its biggest potential.
And as Holly's showing now, he's a tremendous technical wrestler, former tag team champion and intercontinental champion, but now has his eyes set up becoming a three-time Hardcore champion.
And I'll tell you something else, those boys from Alabama, they don't mind hitting and they don't mind getting hit. And they enjoy it, as a matter of fact, when it gets down and dirty, and that's exactly what the Hardcore division is all about. And Holly takes some of the Hardcore strategy and style into his everyday wrestling now.
One of the former Hardcore champions here in the WWF, the Road Dog, who's been having some serious problems with Billy Gunn. After what we saw over the past couple of weeks, it looks like DX is goodbye, and the New Age Outlaws are out too.
Well, Road Dog had engineered an apology from Billy Gunn to X-Pac because of the situation between those two, and Billy Gunn did it. Wait a minute, Holly picking up a chair.
It's
Billy
not a
Gunn.
Hardcore match.
Billy Gunn did apologize to X-Pac and then promptly turned around and just beat him half to death until a Road Dog could intervene, and then Road Dog and Billy Gunn went at it.
So folks, just signed for Over the Edge. Knuckles Nelson now rolls over Holly in a kick out. Just signed for Over the Edge. VA Billy Gunn takes on his former partner, the Road Dog. What an emotional matchup that's gonna be. And tomorrow night, Sunday Night Eat Live, 7 o'clock, 6 Central on USA from Jacksonville, Florida. The Road Dog will meet former friend Triple H.
And that's going to be a heck of a contest, and it's a shame that DX had to splinter in this manner, but you've got to think Triple H is selling out to the corporation, and Billy Gunn's ego, for lack of a better word, for the split up. Road Dogg and X-Pac still as tight as ever, but let's face it, folks, two men do not a DX make, but it's going to be interesting and Over the Edge to see the Outlaws battle each other for, I guess, the first time ever.
And speaking of X-Pac, he'll be in action Over the Edge as well. He and Kane defend the tag team titles against Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown.
It's good to see Sexual Chocolate back, and Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown will be in the tag team title hunt at Over the Edge, as they were when they left off as a result of Mark Henry's knee surgeries. Glad to see that he's now recovered.
Oh! What a shot by Hardcore Holly, in total control now of Knuckles Nelson.
Well, Knuckles Nelson was giving Hardcore Holly a rough way to go just a couple of minutes ago, but Holly turned the tide, and he is in the driver's seat right now and in firm control.
Hardcore Holly again wants another shot at the Hardcore Championship. Right now he's proven to Knuckles Nelson he can get it done both inside and outside the ring.
Look at the power! Look at the power of Holly! He holds the man upside down and slams him with authority.
And this one's over. Hardcore Holly picked up the win over Knuckles Nelson.
Here is your winner, Hardcore Holly!
He has done it all! Like I said, a former professional race car driver, a multi-champion here in the World Wrestling Federation. Now in the hunt for the Hardcore title. Hardcore Holly has come in his own, and he has never looked better.
And Hardcore Holly holding Head hostage. Ransom, another shot at the Hardcore Championship. So Hardcore Holly picked up the win. Both stick around. The High Flying Hardy Boys are next.
And now, the Rescue of the Week, brought to you by the U.S. Coast Guard. Join, and you can save lives every day. Call toll-free 1-877-NOW-USCG.
That's it!
Was brought to you by the U.S. Coast Guard. Join and you can be a hero every day. The U.S. Coast Guard. Jobs that matter.
Back on Shotgun Saturday Night. And here come the Hardy Boys. Matt and Jeff, Deptford tag team action.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Deptford, North Carolina, at a combined weight of 429 pounds, Matt and Jeff, the Hardy Boys.
Matt and Jeff, the Hardy Boys, set to take on Julio Sanchez and Russ Greenberg as we get ready, Jim, for live Sunday Night Heat. Tomorrow night from Jacksonville, Florida. And what in the world is The Rock, broken arm and all, going to have to say about what happened this past Monday night?
And if I was The Rock, I would be very careful, because you know what they say about a one-legged man in a butt-kicking contest? Well, a one-armed man on Sunday Night Heat, when the corporate ministry is around, is not a very good idea either, Michael.
Stone Cold Steve Austin suffering bruised ribs when he was tossed off the stage, but he's going to be okay. And speaking of the rattlesnake, Stone Cold's back on Nash Bridges this Friday night on CBS, 10 Eastern and Pacific. This is Austin's second appearance on the show, the first time Nash Bridges had record ratings.
And Stone Cold Steve Austin, he's everywhere. Jeez, look at Jeff Hardy. I thought he was trying to commit suicide there. He just jumped that high over the top rope. Stone Cold Steve Austin is everywhere, but you know that his heart is going to be in the middle of that ring tomorrow night on Sunday Night Heat. And then again at Over the Edge when he attempts to... Wait a minute. Julio Sanchez starting out quick. When he attempts to get even with the corporate ministry for that attack and assault on his persona.
You talked about where hearts are, where hearts are lying. Well, where does the heart of Deborah and Val Venus lie after what we saw this past Monday night on Raw?
I think there's some sparks going on there between the big Balboski and the prize-winning puppies. And I wouldn't be surprised if Jeff Jarrett doesn't end up, sitting on ice someplace.
Well, it was supposed to have been Sable versus Deborah in an evening gown match. Sable said she was too busy doing another Playboy shoot. She sent in her body double.
God.
Oh, my, Julio Sanchez. And there's a cover to kick out.
Can you believe that? I was about to say, these Hardy Boys, it's been tremendous watching them develop over the past few months as high flyers here in the World Wrestling Federation. But Julio Sanchez is a kid that could surprise everybody. He's put together, he looks good, he's got the experience, and he's got the desire.
And now it's Matt Hardy and Russ Greenberg. Sable, we had said, was supposed to be in that evening gown match. She sent in her so-called stunt double, her body double, Nicole Bass, to take on Deborah.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, Nicole Bass is only a double for Sable if you're Ray Charles or Stevie Wonder, and there is no way on earth that a normal woman is going to compete with a Nicole Bass in any kind of physical encounter.
Nicole Bass, though, felt the wrath of the guitar from Jeff Jarrett. Look at that tremendous maneuver. But Jeff Hardy did not go for the cover there.
And that's a rookie mistake, but you got to remember, Matt Hardy, only 23 years of age. Jeff Hardy, only 20, both of them.
Oh!
Four-year veterans as professionals, and you have got to think they are only getting better. Just, we've seen the improvement in the last few months, and the Hardys really starting to get not only a following, but confidence in that ring.
Confidence enough to wear purple hair, I guess, as Jeff Hardy now hammers away on Julio Sanchez.
Well, you know these kids these days. But baseball slide out, avoid hitting the ropes, and now another baseball slide, and
oh,
good Lord, these guys are, they're moving like whale blubber in an
ice
floe.
Incoming, Matt Hardy,
no! Double clothesline from the top rope, Matt Hardy with a high-risk maneuver, and it could have been all or nothing, and fortunately for Matt, it was all, and he's setting it up. What, geez!
Jeff Hardy over the top rope!
Cannonballed like he was going into a swimming pool to Jeff Hardy. These kids will put their bodies on the line every time you see them.
Hardy Boys, tremendous athletes, tremendous tag team, and now Jeff Hardy in control of Julio Sanchez. What action here on Shotgun Saturday Night. Action's only going to heat up tomorrow night on Sunday Night Heat, live from Jacksonville. Road Dogg and Triple H in action. That's going to be a good one.
Well, like we said, the battle of former DX members, and good Lord, that was a pancake and flip-flop. Gone for the cover.
And a kick out after two.
Julio Sanchez not ready to give it up yet. The battle of former DX members, it's going to be interesting to see exactly what X-Pac thinks of the whole thing, because if you notice that every time a person defects from DX, generally he's the one that gets spat on the way out.
Yeah, X-Pac has been, his friends turn his back on him twice in the last month. It was Triple H at WrestleMania in China, for that matter. And then, of course, Billy Gunn just last week on Sunday Night Heat.
But I'll tell you this, X-Pac has a big, big brother to come to his rescue whenever he is outnumbered and needs a helping hand, and that's Kane, who is... repaid the favor that X-Pac has showed the Big Red Machine by befriending him, by sort of keeping an eye on X-Pac and watching his back
when he gets a two-on-one situation.
And here's Matt Hardy now. Tremendous maneuver on Julio Sanchez. As Russ Greenberg, Sanchez's partner, looks on, that's who Sanchez needs to make a tag to here. Second rope for Matt Hardy. Delivers the elbow to the sternum. But again, taking his time, going for a cover, Jim.
And that, once again, is a mistake that maybe overconfidence that a young man will make. He needs to go for the cover at every opportunity because Julio Sanchez, as he applies the sleeper, has shown that he is a capable opponent, and Julio could score an upset.
And Matt Hardy now with a sleeper of his own. It just dropped Sanchez on his head. Here's a cover now, and Greenberg makes the save.
Greenberg looks like he's one of the American Gladiators or something, for heaven's sake. Greenberg is a licensed real estate agent when he's not wrestling at it. It looks like the Hardys may want to give him a couple of acres.
Julio Sanchez with a swinging neck breaker. And now Sanchez desperately tries to make a tag. And he does. And here comes Greenberg. Momentum shifting here. Greenberg hammering away on Matt Hardy. Standing drop kick just knocked Hardy off his feet.
Greenberg is cooking. Oh! And there's a clothesline. Greenberg, the fresh man, trying to make the most of the opportunity. And he's got the size on both the Hardys. Going to the top. This is Hardy Boys territory.
Chris Greenberg high. There's the crossbody into the lateral press. Hook of the leg. Jeff Hardy makes the save.
Jeff Hardy came right down on Russ Greenberg's the back of his head, and now Matt swinging wild hits him where? There he hits him another one in the back of the head, and Greenberg has effectively been derailed. He was on the express line there for a minute, but the Hardy Boys, once again, the teamwork too much.
Yeah, the express line is ended because the Hardy Boys are in total control right now. Here's the double team. Tremendous suplex by Matt and Jeff Hardy. And look out, we've seen this one before, Jim.
I've never seen any tag team, but the Hardys execute this maneuver from opposite top turnbuckles. They come with the leg and the splash, and that should be it for Russ Greenberg.
And it is. The Hardy Boys pick up the win over Sanchez and Greenberg.
Here are your winners, the Hardy Boys.
Well, you got to say that it was a heck of a contest, and once again, it could have gone either way, especially with Julio Sanchez, but the Hardy Boys come out on top.
We're not through yet. Stick around. We're coming back. Welcome back, everybody. This portion of tonight's show presented by Frem Extra Guard, the only filter with a rough-textured, sure-grip top that makes changing your filter a lot easier.
Gotta watch that sludge, Michael. And by Twix Cookie Bars. Twix, two for me, none for you.
And by 1-800-CALL-ATT for a collect call. Sunny Night Heat live, 7 o'clock, 6 Central on USA tomorrow night. Road Dogg meets Triple H.
Ill will abounds in the former DX members. It could be a full-scale riot. What about The Rock?
Broken arm and all. We'll talk about last Monday's carnage.
That's right. The assault by the corporate ministry on The Rock that left him with a broken arm. The Rock will be there live on Sunday Night Heat, Michael.
For Jim, I'm Michael. We will see you at Heat.